Welcome to Digital Communication Playlist. Here in this session, I'll be going to explain PCM Receiver. So this session is about PCM Receiver. Now see, when we send signal over a channel, there will be a possibility of addition of noise, and when you send it to larger distance, larger noise will get added. So all we do is, when we send PCM signal over a channel, in between that transmitter to receiver, at some position we usually place regenerator. So when you send signal from transmitter to receiver, usually you will be observing there is regenerator. So first I'll explain regenerator block diagram, then I'll explain you PCM receiver. So see, this is what regenerator, or one can say repeater. So where one can observe input signal is distorted PCM. So when you observe that signal, it looks like distorted signal like this. So that is what noise which is added. Now if I say lower voltage, that is assigned with bit 0, and higher voltage, that is assigned with bit 1. So see, this is what 010, that is how data is been given over here to this regenerator repeater. Now when you see this complete block diagram of regenerator repeater, first block is amplitude equalizer. So what it does is, it equalizes input signal which is given over here, and to this equalizer we have timing circuit, and that timing circuit is actually functioning at sampling frequency fs. So this is what timing circuit which is giving sampling frequency fs to equalizer, and same sampling frequency that will be given to decision making device. So based on equalized amplitude, decision making device will give pure digital signal. So at output side of this circuit, you will be finding complete digital signal like this without noise. So here one can observe there is noise added, but after regenerative repeater with this complete circuit, you will be finding signal is pure digital signal. Again, this signal could be retransmitted over a channel. So this regenerative repeater that we use to increase communication distance, the reason is when you send signal, because of attenuation as well as noise, signal will be actually distorted. One can see this is little less distorted signal, but there is a possibility if you send this signal to further larger distance, this signal, this may appear like this, and you'll be finding this signal is actually getting deteriorated as it propagates further. So in between transmitter to receiver, we use regenerative repeater so that we can increase communication distance in between transmitter and receiver. Now let us have a block diagram of PCM receiver. Now see, when you receive signal, you will be having PCM pulse coded modulated signal plus noise signal. So at receiver side, there will be PCM plus noise, and as I have told, that noise that we can remove by using this regenerating circuit, and that is what synchronize with pulse generator. So here pulse generator is generating signal of pulse to synchronize that PCM signal, and that will be having frequency which is sampling frequency. So this is what sampling frequency at which this pulse generator is functioning. So here you will be having pure PCM signal. And this is what serial digital data which will be there over here. So this serial digital data, now that will get converted to serial to parallel converter, and now here you will be finding there is parallel data. So the serial to parallel converter that will convert serial data into parallel, and this parallel data now that will be given to digital to analog converter. So this digital to analog converter that will generate quantized output. So here there will be analog signal at output side, here there will be analog signal at output side, and this signal that will be quantized output. Now when you pass this output analog, or one can say that is what pulse amplitude modulated output. Now when you pass this PAM output through low pass filter, you will be getting message signal. So when you pass it through low pass filter, it will remove unwanted high frequency spectrum, and that will gives you analog message signal at output side. So that is how complete block diagram is there. Again, let us have quick rewind of this. See, your PCM received signal, that will be PCM signal plus noise signal, and that is what we give it to regenerative circuit. And as earlier I have explained, that will generate pure PCM output. So here you will be having pure PCM output, and to have synchronization of that pure PCM output, we have pulse generator which is synchronized to sampling frequency FS. And here this serial digital PCM data that will get translated into parallel digital data, and that will be given to digital to analog converter. This digital to analog converter that will generate analog signal, one can say that is pulse amplitude modulated signal, and that is what quantized output. And here you'll be connecting low pass filter to remove unwanted high frequency spectrum, and you will be receiving message signal at output side. So this is how this circuit functions. But here one thing that one should understand, this output is quantized output, so always there will be quantization error which will appear in message signal. So let us try to understand that. Like, see, as I have told earlier, we have quantized output. So this is what by black color one can observe. This is quantized output, right? And by this red color one can observe this is actual input. Now if you see the difference in between quantized output and actual input, so that is what quantization error. So that one can see over here by green color. So here, see, this is what quantization error, that is what difference in between input and quantized output. Like, see over here, one can see this is what quantization error. So that one can see over here, that is there in this shape, right? See, for example, over here this difference is this much. So this is what quantization error, and that one can see it is over here, right? So this is what quantization error, that is what difference in between actual signal and quantized sampled output. Now I'll sum up this session by explaining few basic formulas. Like, see, when you have quantized output, that is having quantization error, and that quantization error depends on number of levels. If you have larger number of levels, in that case quantization error will decrease. But when you have larger number of levels, at that time you will have to represent quantized output with large number of bits, so your bandwidth will increase. So more the number of samples, larger the bandwidth, and less the quantization error. So as if you increase number of level, quantization error will decrease, but it will increase bandwidth. So number of quantization level L, that depends on number of bits which represents levels. So if I say if n equals to number of bits per sample, so in that case number of quantization level, that will be 2 to the power n. So if you have 4 bits, then number of quantization level will be 2 to the power 4, means 16 quantization level will be there. Now if you want to calculate step size, so step size, that is delta. Now that step size, that we can calculate by higher voltage minus lower voltage divided by number of quantization level, where number of quantization level, that we can calculate by 2 to the power n, where n is number of bits to represent one sample. And this is what even I have derived in my previous session of quantization. You can see my all sessions based on quantization, you will be finding this calculation. Mean square error, that even I have derived. Mean square error can be calculated by delta square by tel. So this is even I have derived. You can see my previous session based on quantization. I have derived this. And signal to noise ratio, SNR, that one can calculate by 1.76 plus 6.02 n. So this is what exact value. In some books you will be finding it is given by 1.8 plus 6 n. So this is even I have derived in my previous session. You can check out all those videos where you will be getting how these formulas have derived. Here I am just giving you little idea, like see how to calculate those quantization level, quantization error and signal to noise ratio of quantization. Thank you so much for watching this video. You can give me your valuable suggestions. Definitely based on your suggestions, in future I will try to make videos to sort out all those queries which you have right now. Thank you so much for watching this video.